Rates across all Philippine T-bill tenors inch higher Monday ahead of the central bank's policy meeting. The Bureau of Treasury only partially awarded its 20 billion peso offering for the week. It widely expects the Banco Central ng Pilipinas to hold off on a rate hike when new BSP Governor Benjamin Diokno presides over his first monetary policy meeting on Thursday.
We awarded partially only, given that we do not see the need for any significant increase in the rates. No, significant meaning to say for like 91 day, especially they were asking for 15 basis points higher than the secondary rates right now. So with decelerating inflation, and at the same time, we all know na given also the projections na yung BSP when they will hold their policy meet on Thursday, most likely they will hold rates steady. No, it would be a pause.
These expectations bolster the Bureau's decision, even as banks asked for higher rates following the 236 billion peso retail bond offering last week, which was seen to have siphoned off a lot of liquidity from the market. The agency earlier said it plans to raise 360 billion pesos domestically for the Philippines' budgetary requirements.
But we see that yung banks, they're charging higher rates, particularly on the short end of the curve, given yung funding cost right now ng banks is higher, no? Because, they say because of the tight liquidity. So, the yield curve is relatively flat because of expectations na inflation would be tracking back to the 2-4% path of the BSP.
Analysts agree the Monetary Board will leave the reverse repurchase policy rate untouched, even if the new governor is widely seen to be dovish, given his expansionary policies as budget chief for the past years.
I know the governor said that he will be pro-growth, but the BSP actually follows a much longer forecasting horizon. So when they do change their track, definitely they will be looking at the implications 2 years down the line. So I don't think there will be major moves now.
I think it's been highly expected that rates will remain the same, and that's our position as well.
But for ING Bank Manila, the market is ripe for a cut in bank's reserve requirement ratio, which is pegged at 18%. It explains liquidity has become tight in the past months, with money supply growth grinding to single digits and short-term time deposit rates rising to nearly 4.8%. Diokno has earlier said he's open to cutting the triple R by as much as 400 basis points in the next four quarters. Bruce Rodriguez, ABS-CBN News.